The Labour Party has described as embarrassing and depressing that the Supreme Court would, after hearing his appeal and that of its presidential candidate, Mr. Peter Obi, against the judgment of the Presidential Election Petition Court, PEPC, that upheld Bola Tinubu's election, it refused to deliver any judgment. The party also said it is a breach of its constitutional right that the Appeals Court failed to avail it a certified true copy, the CTC, of the judgment it delivered in respect of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, appeal. The party national secretary, Alhaji Omar Farouk, at a press conference on Tuesday, disclosed that the Supreme Court, after delivering judgment in the appeal filed by the PDP in October 26, the presiding judge, Justice John Eyong Okoro, verbally stated that the decision in the Labour Party appeal would abide by the judgment just delivered in respect of the PDP appeal. Farouk said the party finds the position taken by the Supreme Court regarding the judgment in appeal extraordinary, terribly shocking, most unprecedented, and unacceptable. He argued that the appeals filed by both the PDP and Labour Party from the Court of Appeal to the Supreme Court were different, which he explained emanated from two separate judgments of the Court of Appeal. According to him, the two appeals were not even consolidated at the Supreme Court, but were heard separately, adding that the question was never raised, the parties never agreed, and the courts neither gave a directive nor order that the judgment in one appeal would abide by the decision in the other. The petitions from where the two appeals arose were held separately at the Court of Appeal based on separate pleadings and different sets of witnesses. Thus, the facts of the two petitions were remarkably different. The National Secretary stated that the only issue that the parties agreed on is the two appeals worth 25% vote in Abuja. The other issues submitted to the Supreme Court for determination in the two appeals differ remarkably, he added, pointing out that the issues of forfeiture of funds being proceeds of narcotics trafficking were contained only in the Labour Party petition. Farouk also disclosed that the Labour Party's appeal included double nomination of the third respondent, Shettima, which he said was not even in the PDP's petition. The failure to comply with the mandatory requirement of Section 73(2) of the Electoral Act 2022, as well as the effect of the certified true copies of 18,123 blurred and unreadable polling unit result sheets from EC8A, downloaded from the IREV, issued by the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, to the Labour Party and its candidate, which was tendered in court. Same were blank A4 papers, the pictures and images of unknown persons. They were purported to be copies of polling unit results, even with the materiality of the issue. The Court of Appeal avoided making a finding on it, he added. The National Secretary further disclosed that the Labour Party had, in its letter, dated October 26, applied to the Chief Registrar of the Supreme Court for the certified true copy of the judgment and a reminder on November 8, but regretted that requests were ignored. He added that the party is aware that by the provision of Section 294, one in brackets of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria 1999, as amended. Every court established under the Constitution, which necessarily include the Supreme Court, has a duty to finish all parties to the case of matter determined with duly authenticated copies of decision within 7 days of the delivery thereof. So the Supreme Court has failed to do this in the present appeal. This is how Nigeria has gradually turned to something else. It's a shame. Judiciary that's supposed to be the last man hope, the common man hope. People are now afraid now to go to the courts. So who do you now run to? The electoral body cannot tell you the truth. Nigerian judiciary cannot speak the truth. The police cannot save you. Who do you now run to? Nigeria don't scatter. Nigeria don't scatter. And for you to understand that these people, they understand what they are doing. You understand? They know, say, they don't do waiting they're not supposed to do. And you know, when you want to prove, or when you want to show the right thing, when you have done the wrong thing, you go hook. So they are just trying to avoid all these things because they know, say, they go hook. Just see what is happening in Kano State. Then they hook. When you don't do the wrong thing, you will continue to do the wrong thing. Nigerians, truth be said, all is not well in this country. That is just the only thing I want to say here. Well, let's hear from you. What's your take on this? Kindly share your thoughts below the comment section. And don't forget to give us a thumbs up.